Some of the warning signs, of course, prior to us coming together, were very vivid in the public arena. We started with the invocation of Article 31 of the laws of Zambia on 5th October 2017 by the Republican President Edgar Chagwarungu. This action, of course, effectively facilitated for the institution of a threatened state of emergency under which citizens would arbitrarily be arrested without cause. And about the same time, Zambia's main opposition leader from the United Party for National Development, Mr. Hakainde Hichilema, was arrested on treason charges, which carries a maximum penalty of death sentence. And then during the same period, we also witnessed some civil society activists from the then Zambian Council for Social Development, Mr. Mwape, our Alliance for Community Action, our comrade, Madame Laura, and indeed some of our colleagues from the media as well as from the musical sector. They were arrested when they were protesting against government's imprudent expenditure on the fire tenders. In the recent past, we've also witnessed the deportation of the Zimbabwean civil society leader, Tendai Biti, who was deported despite a court order. Not to mention the Kenyan professor, who was also not allowed entry into Zambia because of the purported presentation he was going to make during a graduation ceremony. In Dola also, we saw some pastors and civil society colleagues, you know, being arrested for merely assembling to discuss the national budget. Further also, citizens have witnessed increasing muzzling of the press, effectively curtailing freedom of expression as espoused in the national constitution. Of course, the critical media are continuously facing harassment. The case of Prime TV journalists is very fresh in our minds, apart from the issue of the mask, of course, that has been with us.